In my previous video, I showed you how to install Kuka's HMI Easy Options package, as well as setting up your first basic HMI. That's all well and good, if a little boring. Now let's do some more exciting elements, such as controlling digital IOs, creating our own variables, and even dynamic images. So let's get started. Let's load up Work Visual to set up our new HMI using Kuka HMI Easy. Browse for our connected robot using the Work Visual Project Explorer, where we're going to select our current active project, shown with a green arrow. This takes a short moment to load. In the Project Structure tab, we can double-click our cell window. If we look at our button ribbon, we can see many of our options are grayed out and unavailable. If we double-click our KRC controller to set that as our active controller. To avoid saving over my initial project, we will save this as a copy, file, save as, and call it HMI tutorial. Now that we have a fresh project without writing over the active one on the pendant, we can start HMI Easy. It's possible to open HMI Easy with this button on the toolbar or in the Editor's menu under the Options Packages HMI Easy Management. Clicking this opens up our HMI Easy Management tab in the primary window. Here we have a few buttons: Add, Configure, Delete, Rename, Duplicate, Import and Export our HMIs. We are going to create a new HMI and call it Gripper HMI. Click OK and we have a new blank HMI. If we double click to open the HMI Easy Editor tab, Kuka HMI is incredibly easy and accessible. We have the main preview of the HMI, which shows us a single tab to start. The Catalog tab features all the elements we can click and drag onto the canvas. The Properties tab that displays the currently selected object's properties, including column position. A new HMI defaults to two columns, but under the Tab tab, we can increase it up to four. To create a new tab, we simply right-click the New Tab button at the bottom of our HMI canvas and select New Tab. Under the Tab menu, we can then rename the selected tab. And the final tab is the settings for the overall HMI. We can change the window title to something like Gripper Status. The menu item is what the button is named as it's displayed on the pendant that we access our HMI with. Let's call it Carl's HMI. The position of menu item is where it will be displayed on the pendant's menu. 1000 will push it to the bottom, and a higher number means closer to the top. And finally, to display the menu item on the pendant, it's required to check the Generate Menu Item box. A key feature of HMI Easy is that you're allowed to have up to 5 tabs, and creating custom and clean user interfaces is the primary purpose of this options package. So with all this in mind, let's create our first HMI. Under the Catalog tab, let's click and drag a text box to our canvas to give the HMI a title. Firstly, it needs a title. Let's call it Gripper. Make the column width 2 and change the horizontal alignment to middle and the vertical alignment to top. And let's also increase the font size to 30. Next, we'll put in the image of the Gripper. We already have an image item on the canvas. Simply click to modify its properties. Let's make it bigger, so set the column width and row height both to 4. No need for a title in this instance. Set both horizontal and vertical alignment to middle. It's required to provide a file path to the image you wish to be selected. I already have a couple images. One of the Gripper open and one of it closed, but they're currently on my local computer and will not appear within the project. Let's put them into our project by going over to the project structure, selecting the Files tab, and drop down the controller. C, KRC, user, into the HMI Easy folder. Simply right-click to create a new folder. Let's call it Gripper HMI. Then it's as simple as clicking and dragging our open image over our newly created folder. Now if we drop our new folder, we can select our image. If we look in the Work Visual Properties tab, we see the action parameter is the file path of our image as it exists within the project. Simply select all and copy, then paste it in the HMI Easy Properties tab's path text box. Now that we have our first image, let's create a HMI Easy element with a variable, such as the velocity of the Kuka. For this, we'll simply click and drag a new slider onto our canvas. Change its header to speed. And the variable we want to change is $OV_pro. For this variable, we want a bit more fidelity, so let's increase the column width to 4. Now that we have a few elements on our canvas, let's deploy it to the Kuka controller. It's as easy as clicking the deploy button on the main toolbar and ensure our active Kuka is selected. Prior to deploying, we must ensure we are logged on the pendant as an expert user. On the pendant, simply hit the user group button, select expert and sign in. Back in Work Visual, hit next to generate the code. Hit next again to deploy our code to the Kuka. Next again to activate the project. But this will pause for user input on the pendant. If we check the pendant, we have a dialog box asking if we want to activate our project. Hit yes. This will, of course, save the current project and installs our new project. It displays the changes we are about to make. Hit yes to continue, and the install takes place. This is a new project installation. It won't automatically display. So let's close the project management window. Hit the navigator button to display the main menu, select display, and we see our HMI is not yet visible. As it's a brand new HMI, the control PC requires a restart. Under the main menu, select shutdown, followed by reboot control PC. Once the control PC has rebooted, we can go back into the main menu, hit display, and see our brand new HMI is now listed. If we select that, it will load our HMI displaying the image, but the velocity slider is currently greyed out and inaccessible, but we have both our tabs accessible. The cause of the slider not being active is that it has a required user level. So let's switch back over to expert, and now our slider is active. If we change it, we can see the velocity is updating on the robot status at the top of the screen. These are pretty straightforward elements, so let's get a little bit more complicated and try modifying the state of the gripper. First, click and drag a push button element onto our canvas to where we want to position it. Select the new element, and HMI Easy automatically switches over to the Properties tab. For the Contents button variable, let's use Open, and no need for the header, so remove that. The variable we will be changing is the digital I/O to open our gripper, which is number 16. So that means the variable is $out, square brackets, and the number 16. And we want the press value to equal true and set the horizontal alignment to middle. Let's repeat for the closed state. Which is the digital I/O 15. why we're here. What if we put in a different type of slider, a numeric slider, and set it to the same variable as our speed slider? Change the increment step to 5 and increase its column width to 4. Now that we have a few new elements, let's deploy it to the Kuka and check it. Back on our pendant, we confirm that we want to overwrite our project. Because we've already installed this project previously, we can see our changes without rebooting the control PC. If we test the new numeric slider, we see it updates our old one as they share the same variable. Also, the new slider increases and decreases in increments of 5, as we set in HMI Easy. It doesn't matter which slider we change. Everywhere on our pendant that is referenced to our velocity variable updates accordingly. You can see the open and close push buttons are grayed out and inaccessible, even though we're logged in as an expert. This is because we require the dead man switch to be activated, meaning we have to switch to the physical pendant. If we hold down the dead man switch halfway as we're activating the actuators, we get green across the board that it's good to go, and make sure we're logged in as an expert as well. If we press the closed button, the gripper closes, and open opens the gripper. This is a pretty basic setup for our HMI, so in the next part of my HMI Easy tutorials, we're going to set up our own custom global variables that will be able to change the image to match the state of the gripper, as well as introduce a couple new elements. So come back for the next part.